Welcome in Amsterdam. This is the Eurocree Daily. We share your passion for hospitality excellence.
Of course, yeah, we all have read the books about how you have to do it. But how is it in real practice? And I have been also the CEO of the Dutch Tours Board for 7 years. And I've had long discussions with ministers, mayors of big cities about how to do destination branding. And that's my story. So let's start. We start with a brand that is a mental picture between your ears. And this is how it starts. This is how your holiday starts. You go to the travel agency, you have a brochure, and you think, oh, well, that looks nice, and the pictures are beautiful, so up you go. And you fly, and maybe you all notice this feeling when you land and you look out of the window of your airplane and you see this beautiful new land you've never seen. If you come for the first time in Japan or Thailand, you think, hey, gosh, yeah, the mental picture of the brand is between your ears and I'm going to see those things I've seen in the brochure. So your expectations are very high. And then you come in the arrival hall. For those of you who have been arriving in Delhi 2 years ago or 3 years ago, yeah, very funny. Yeah, you see a completely different picture, your country. But this is, let's say this is Thailand, and you have that first sense of arrival. And then you be transferred and you go to your hotel and you all know this feeling. You stand at the swimming pool with your wife and you're saying, gosh, this it is. This is my destination. This is the brand I love. I'm going on holiday here. And I'm completely satisfied because I paid my money for the product that I expect to get back. It's like a Coca-Cola bottle. Yeah, you order Coca-Cola and you don't think I get water. No, you get Coca-Cola. So this is what you expect. And then the next morning, this happens. You go to the beach and you sit there and you watch your grandson, yeah, it's not my grandson, but you watch them. And suddenly my wife says, what about a tsunami? What will happen then? And I think, gosh, I've not thought about that. Yeah, but there we see a friction between the brand image and suddenly something completely unexpected that happened in the past. And this is the problem that Coca-Cola also has and McDonald's. When there's something in the food, yeah, that should not belong there, we have a problem, yeah, for the brand. And yes, we have riots in Thailand, we have no strikes in France, yeah? And how does that fit then with the brand? So can we control the product in destination marketing? Can you control the taxi driver, yeah, that brings you from Schiphol here to the hotel? Did he charge you the right price for the trip? Probably not. So that is one of the difficulties we have in branding when we talk about destination branding. And I was thinking when I was reading Business Week, yeah, the brand name of Coca-Cola is worth $67 billion, yeah, dollars, yeah, or millions, yeah, but it is $67 billion worth. Now that is a value that has been calculated by the people who are working at Wall Street and other, yeah, financial institutions. So that should be correct, I think. If you go to destinations, there's one destination that immediately can say, this is my brand name and this is the value, $27 billion for Disney. Now Disney, ladies and gentlemen, controls everything. The moment you enter the gates, the moment you enter the parking lots, to the Coca-Cola, to the drinks, to the attractions, when something's happening, yeah, they control the whole thing. When something goes wrong, when a girl is missing in Disney Park, yeah, the PR takes over and there's damage control and everything is under control. That is how they protect the brand name Disney. Is that happening in Paris? Is that happening in Amsterdam? Number two. in destination branding is McDonald's. 27. And they control again everything from the hamburger. Yeah, the number of salads is in it, yeah, the number of tomatoes. IKEA, another destination. There was an interview with a manager of a zoo that is doing not so well in Holland. And he said, yes, it's about all the people go to IKEA these days. IKEA is like an attraction park. And in fact, it is true. For €1, you can have breakfast there. Yeah? Pizza Hut. Who wants to compare Paris with Pizza Hut? But Pizza Hut has a more value in their brand name than whole Paris. And the same is with Starbucks, a destination nobody had heard about, I think, 10 years ago. Did you know Starbucks? These days, if I'm in Shanghai, I cannot escape. My wife wants to go to Starbucks because that's the best place to get coffee. Yeah? So she has found that destination, yeah, and she goes there. And I was thinking, what in the heck I'm doing? I'm CEO of Holland Promotion, and I must promote the brand name Holland. And my wife goes to Starbucks because she believes in the brand. Does she believe in the brand name Holland? Yeah, that is how the discussion started at home. Yeah, and I want to continue the discussion here. So, my statement is that commercial destinations like Disney and Universal Studios, yeah, they are not discovered anymore. Yeah, they are created by a lot of advertisement campaigns, by one manager who is in charge of the advertisement. And he decides exactly the policy with one manager who is in charge of the product of the destination. So this is about commercial destinations. And believe me or not, cities and countries are having more and more competition with these artificial destinations. Yes, we don't like them. I don't like them. I hate them sometimes. Yeah, I've been the managing director of Six Flags Holland. I'm sorry. Also one of the things I've done for another 7 years. As an amusement park, yeah, also a destination. Completely artificial. I like to go to other places where I can discover things. But if you talk about branding, yeah, let's have a look at Dubai. Yes, of course. I know a lot of things are going wrong in Dubai. But this sheikh, he had a vision. He had absolutely a vision. He said, okay, at this moment I have a desert. I have no hotels, no attractions, nothing. So I'm going to build them. And I, out of nowhere, yeah, 20 years ago, you had not thought you were going to Dubai. I will go there on holiday. Yeah, in January, yeah, because that destination completely artificial created, and what he also did, he created an airline called Emirates. And in the newspapers, it was that Emirates has now ordered, I think, about 30 of the new Airbuses 380 that can hold 600 people. 30, KLM, zil, Air France, one, yeah. And here is a destination that creates an airline, creates a completely, yeah, hotels and entertainment. If it will be a success, I don't know yet. But anyway, he did it. There's another man, as the president or the of Singapore. This man, I don't know if you have seen an interview from him, yeah, he believes in tourism and in conventions. Yeah. And I have been at Sentosa Island a few months ago. Beautiful conference facilities, hotels, yeah, and Singapore itself clean. Taxi drivers, great, yeah. Rickshaw drivers don't go there because they, yeah. But anyway, there is a discipline, yeah, and by that way you can create a brand. Now this is not a democracy, and China is the same. The 70 million visitors that went to the World Expo was announced today that they achieved their budget. They were simply sent there in buses. Yeah? And that is how you can create 70 million visitors to a World Expo. But we don't live in Singapore, the most of you. We do not live in Dubai. We live in democracies. And that's great. But it has one downside. We have not one boss, but we have 16 million bosses here in Holland, for example, who everybody has an opinion. And everybody, yeah, it is their product, yeah, and they want to talk about it. And that is great, that is positive, but can you build a brand with 16 million directors of marketing? Yeah, that is a little bit difficult. So that is why I asked the questions. Yeah, can indeed democratic cities and countries be branded? And I think yes, at the end I will end positive. Yeah, but I promise you, you have also something to discuss during drinks. So there is a nation branding index 2010, and that is being produced by Mr. Anholt. Maybe a few of you know him, and I think that's great what he's doing. And I beg you all here, all professors and all research people, please continue with the research. My story is not meant that you stop. My story is just meant to stimulate you to continue in your study and to produce papers, yeah, about branding, how you should do it, yeah, and how we can involve. So yes, Mr. Anholt started with the Nation Branding Index 2010. I think he started in 2005 or 2000 with this. This is great. And now the United States is number one, the number one brand. That's funny, because when you Google on, for example, unitedstates.com, yeah, or newyork.com, yeah, and if you look, is there any national tourism office anymore in the United States? Also gone. Yeah. So how this has come? Yeah, that the United States is number one. Anyway, the same is with Germany, France, United Kingdom. Yeah. But at least here's a basic research done to come to an index of brands of nations. And my challenge to all this intellectual capital here in this room, continue the research and let's see how we can improve this. Sometimes, you know, my job has been a long time to talk with ministers and burgomeisters and be very official. And yes, they pay you, so you're not going to tell them you're wrong. Yeah, but then they say, we did a great campaign. And then you say, yes, of course, let's have a drink. Yeah, we have to watch this, because there's a lot of air in the room sometimes. And yeah, but this is the best destination promotion I have ever known. My teacher telling me where Amsterdam was, where Bangkok was, where Paris. And that was the moment that my dreams started of those far away destinations. That is why I still want to go, yeah, to Indonesia, because it was on the map all the time and people talked about it when I was six. And I want to go there, I want to see that. And I think teachers, especially teachers from geography, are the best pushers of destination travel, yeah, in the world. So, yeah, and if you see here from this picture and think about yourself, yeah, how you have been looking and dreaming to the maps, yeah, in the classroom if you were bored. Books, Anne Frank, for those of you who have time, have not been at Anne Frank Museum here in Amsterdam, the whole long line, yeah, about more than 1 million people each year come to Amsterdam and go to Anne Frank. Simply book, and they go there. Yeah, the same as the Da Vinci Code. I flew with Ryanair to Rome, and I was looking to people in the cabin, and I saw a lot of people had Da Vinci Code with them. Yeah, and then suddenly it dawned on me: hey, they're going to look up the places, yeah, of the Da Vinci Code. And the same is with Lord of the Rings. New Zealand, yeah, has made a lot of promotion out of that. So books are great, but they are by accident, yeah, that they discuss a destination. Films. I have two sons, And they want to go to New York, because there it is happening. I said, have you been in New York? No, only once. Yeah, but how do you come to your vision of New York as a brand? He said, it's a great destination, we see it on television every day. A lot of fun, movies, that's the place where it happens. I said, yeah, but most of the movies are not shot in New York. They're shot off or in Chicago, yeah, or in California, yeah. But they create an image of the place of New York. That is maybe not the real New York. But anyway, those four films, yeah, have made New York, and we can find maybe 10 more. So films and destination promotion are interlinked. Funny, the Amsterdam government has decided not to participate anymore in foreign films. Yeah, because it upset the people locally that the road is closed. Yeah, which I think is wrong. Yeah, but anyway, here we see the tension between the 16 million managing directors, yeah, who or 5 million who have an other opinion than the other one, yeah, who wants to do it. Sport events. I think Beijing did a tremendous good job. I mean, the opening ceremony of the Olympic Games was one big promotion of Beijing. And I've been at the Games. In the beginning it was a little bit funny, you know, awkward. Yeah, you were being searched and etc. But I have had the best time in Beijing. Never a dull moment. I never felt scared. And they created, there was an article, they created about, they say, about $4 billion US dollars in publicity. Yeah, so that is added to the value of the name Beijing, which I think is good. On the cost side, on the other hand, yeah, I think the cost was way out of balance. The same with South Africa, football. Everybody was scared. Can they do it? Can they not do it? But they did it. I think the image of South Africa has been improved because they handled the games well. Only those horrible tutors they should take away. And SAIL Amsterdam, I think, is also a very good event. But events have a product life cycle. It could be it is at the top, yeah, and it goes back, goes down. So maybe we should come with a new event in the coming time. It's also an event that fits to Amsterdam. In my discussion with burgomasters and ministers, I've always said, you find an event that fits your city, and not that is awkward, doesn't belong there, because people feel that. And I'm not saying because Saxion is in Deventer, but I think the city of Deventer, yeah, has made a number of events that exactly fit in the image of the city, which is okay. Yeah, this is something else. I tried when I was the minister of, when I did CEO of Tourism Board, to make a connection with the economic department. That Made in Holland was the same, yeah, used the same logo as we did, in vain. Yeah, because we were industry and tourism. Tourism? Yeah, is that industry? Yeah. So yeah, you have to bring those groups together. Yeah, and finally we achieve. But that's a big challenge. And I think, especially in the coming decades, when Made in France is becoming much more important than it was in the past, because what is left? Most of the things are made in China these days. So let's be proud that on those things that we still can make in our countries. And let those two connect together. So my theory is that without a proper brand management, yeah, this type of promotion will create only what I say a rumor in the market, but not a brand, because a brand is consistent. Yeah, like the Coca-Cola brand, you know what you buy, you know what you get Coca-Cola, yeah, and not something else. And sometimes I have said to ministers and burgomasters, they should go back to the hotel schools or to the tourism schools, yeah, and get a re-education before they start dictating what the policy should be in tourism. Yeah, it's very funny. To be a political person, you don't need a diploma. If, for everything, you need a master's or a bachelor degree, but you can become a minister without any diploma. So, especially in tourism, that should be applied, I think. Now, let's go quickly, because we have still a few minutes left. A destination brand should be protected by trademark law. When I entered the office of the Dutch Tourism Board, one of my first questions is, who owns the brand Holland? Everybody looked at me and said, brand owned? I said, well, we promote the brand Holland. Do we own it? No. I said, okay, the first thing we do, we're going to own the brand Holland and we make an agreement that we are the owners. Yeah? And I did that, and from that moment, my future was terminated. Because, you know, all the civil servants of the Minister of Economic Affairs were furious at me. What are you doing now? You own the brand? And I said, yes, and now you have to come to me and you have to ask me permission, and I give you a franchise, you can use the brand Holland. Yeah, you laugh about it, but for me, my career was nearly finished at that moment. But that you should do. Who owns the brand France? Yeah? Okay. The logo must be recognizable. There are many people who ask me, why do you use this tulip? Can you eat it? Yes, you can during the war, yeah? But why do you use it? Are tulips the most important thing? Then I say to those people, is the shell of, the symbol of Shell, yeah? Is that what Shell does? No, you recognize the company Shell because of the shell. And the tulip Holland is only because then you recognize Holland. Like Ireland has the four leaves. And so it has nothing to do with tulips or flowers, yeah? Sorry, go too quick. A brand name, easy to translate. We had a problem in Holland. Le Pays-Bas, the Nederlanden, yeah, Nederland, yeah, so we choose Holland. Everybody knows now Holland is an easy name, yeah, in all languages. Price and quality control of the product. I'm very sure that nearly all of you have been in Venice and have been at San Marco Polo Square and you ordered their cappuccino. That was great, until you got the bill, yeah? 18 euros, yeah, for one cup, something like that. Now, this is funny. So everybody promotes Go to Venice, Italian tourist board, and when you are there, yeah, 18 euro. So are you coming back? No. So, and then the last line, a consistent long-term policy for branding and product development. That is the most difficult thing. When I was CEO of the Dutch Tourist Board, during 7 years, I had four different ministers of economic affairs. And all four had a complete different strategy in promoting Holland. And I was going from the left to the right. Yeah, and that is something that should be dictated in concrete and for the coming 10 years. Disney is also not changing their strategy. Coca-Cola also not. So why should countries do that? Because then you cannot build up a brand. This is also, in today's marketing, the website is extremely important. Twitter is important, everything, electronical. So the first thing you should do when you do a campaign, you have the URL, claim the URL, and make it your ownership. If you look up Big Apple these days, bigapple.com, complete different site. I don't know who's behind it, but it is not an official site. And the same problem we had in Holland as well, the campaign I Amsterdam has been developed because the amsterdam.com was in the hands of a number of people I don't want to meet tonight. Yeah? So you have to watch it, who owns the URL, and what do you do about it? And the same we had with holland.com, but we got that back, and 25,000 euro, which was a good price. Now, this is brand architecture. If you have the city of Paris, which is in France, how can you combine that? Unilever does it with Unox, and does it with ice creams, They all have the Unilever brand in the bottom. They're part of the family. Well, this was the second time in my career that I was nearly finished, because I tried to explain to Amsterdam that the logo Holland did belong under their I Amsterdam. Yeah. Which they said, no, we are Amsterdam. Holland, but you're part of Holland. Yeah. So this is what we call brand architecture in destination branding. And I think this should be also a rule. So if you are in Oslo, you see the Norwegian national logo under it, then you know they belong to one family. And this, to whom do you go when you're not satisfied about the service of this hotel? You go to the manager, yeah? But to whom do you go if you find something else? Yeah? Look this up. I have had experience in that, and it's very funny if you say to a tourist board department, guys, this is part of our job. Most of them, they say, we do only promotion. I said, yes, you do promotion, but you do also complaint handling, because that belongs together if you do brand management. I can challenge you, ask tourist board if they have a department that does complaint handling. Very, very few. And this, it's not a fun site. But I tell you, those of you who come from France, yeah, probably your train is not driving back. Can you go to Maison de la France and check there? Yeah. Now, so we promote the destination France or Paris. Now the trains are out of order. Can I look it up at the tourist board site of Paris? That is complaint handling, because you push me to go there. The trains don't go. Yeah. Now, this sound may be exaggerated, but with 9/11, we had Schiphol full with stranded passengers of Americans. It took 2 days before the Dutch government realized we had a problem at our hands, yeah, that these were customers who have been customers in Holland, and they were mad at the Dutch public affairs, because how do they come back? And there was no information. The same is with the cow disease of animals. Yeah. If you're in Ireland, in the UK, when cities are closed, where can you find the correct information if you want to go on holiday? And see the same if you want to go to Thailand. We should improve this together with tour operators. Yeah. And then I'm nearly finished, and you can have your beer and your cocktails and your wine. This, ladies and gentlemen, is extremely important. You hold the future of our industry in your hands. It is up to you to educate the youngsters that will come and serve our guests. Yeah. And without staff training and hospitality training, we are zil. And I believe that you work for, let's say, the industry of the future. Yeah. A lot of industries are going up to China. So let's the Chinese come here and let's receive them. Let's put them on holiday here. Yeah, let them relax. This is what global economy is all about. Yeah, and so I think in this global economy, it will be great. And I'm absolutely honored that I can speak in front of you, and I wish you a lot of luck in your future career. So let's summarize. In my opinion, if you want to succeed in destination branding or building up a destination brand, try to control the product as much as possible, including the taxi drivers. Yeah, have a consistent promotion all the time. Don't go swap around. Look to your distribution, look to your URLs. Yeah, how do I do this consequently? Can I do anything of price control? Yeah, personnel. The P from personnel, the training, do it. And then I put down permanent, consistent public-private cooperation. That is where our political people should come in. They should bring them all together, because in our industry, it is the aeroplane, it is the taxi driver, it is the restaurant, it is the hotel, it is the sightseeing that makes the product. They should be combined, and the political people should be more aware that they should have some kind of role in that. And then I want to finish. Seventh is passion. No destination can grow and can be successful if the people there have not the passion to be friendly, to be nice, and that people want to receive customers and celebrate with them all the nice things they have. Thank you very much. Have a nice drink.
Welcome in Amsterdam. This is the Eurocree Daily. We share your passion for hospitality excellence.